Of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord that they should praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army and to say, praise the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. I stand here today faced with the monumental task of providing words of encouragement and support for this great pastor on her day of celebration. It's a celebration because she has been successful in carrying out her assignment from the Lord even until now. My subject tonight is leadership worth following. Would you repeat that after me? Leadership worth following. My subtopic is the pastor, her prayers, her press, and her praise. With God on her side, she is armed and dangerous. I am sure that we are doing the right thing being here this evening, first of all, because today, even when I look in the Word of God, it says the same thing. It commands us in 1 Timothy chapter 5 and 17. It says, let the elders that rule well be counted worthy of double honor, especially they who labor in word and doctrine. Verse 18, for the scripture saith, thou shalt not muzzle the ox that treadeth out the corn. And the laborer is worthy of his or her hire. 1 Corinthians chapter 9 and 14 states, even so hath the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel. It's right to be here. I am convinced this evening that God makes selections of people to be pastors. This office of the pastor is not like any other occupation that you would know of. You must be chosen of God. Jeremiah 3 and 15, it states, I will give you pastors after my own heart, saith the Lord, who will feed you with knowledge and understanding. I am convinced that leadership is worth following. And I am also convinced that some leadership is not worth following. Let's look at leadership that's worth following. Those who are worth it, normally they command certain characteristics in their lives, just as Pastor Hollins does. Number one, praise God, characteristic that all great leaders have is that they live lives with a clear conscience. Number two, they are those who live with integrity. And then number three, they are those who love the Lord with all of their heart. They love their family and they love their church. Great leaders handle success and failure well. A willingness to be misunderstood, praise God. They have that ability that even when they're misunderstood, they're able to know how to communicate with their sheep. They have the same standards at home and at work. They are the same in private as well as they are when they are in the public. David was worth following according to scripture because he had a repentant heart and he loved God's people. Moses was a great leader and he was worth following. Why? He prayed for Israel, praise God, his people, even when they knew that they were wrong. And even though he knew they were wrong, yet he prayed and sought God's compassion and mercy for Israel. Joseph was a great leader because in spite of his many persecutions, he still said, how can I turn against a God who has been so good to me? Yeah. He told his brothers, you did it to me for evil, but God meant it for my good. Dorcas was even a great leader. Praise God, this great woman is called great today because in Joppa, in the book of Acts, it states she was great because she was noted for taking care of the poor. She sold clothes for many of the navy men's families that when they went out to war, their families would yet be clothed. Paul was a great Christian leader. In spite of his thorn in the flesh, he remained faithful to the God his salvation, and he finished his course. Can you say amen? Amen. So we know today that leadership is worth following. Now, what is leadership? Leadership is the art of motivating a group of people to act toward and to do the same thing. It is motivating people that they can be able to achieve their goals together. Praise God. When we look at the word work, it means the quality of a thing that makes it valuable. Following is simply, praise God, going or coming after one before you. Leadership truly is worth following. In the history of our text in Hebrews chapter 13, the Apostle Paul, who is the writer of this letter, is writing to the Christian churches that are scattered abroad throughout Rome and throughout Greece and Asia. He wrote to request of them and to warn them of three major points. First, he requested of them in the text to respect the brothers and sisters in the body of Christ everywhere and to love one another. Number two, he requested of them, don't forget to entertain strangers. That dealt primarily with how to treat people you have not met before. But then he escalates in his teaching to the point that we're celebrating today. The Apostle Paul told the churches and he warned the churches and said, I quote, remember them that have the rule over you, for they watch for your soul. It is something about the pastors that God has given these angels the responsibility of watching over the sheep. You may not agree with them at times. You may disagree with them at other times. But they have the responsibility to watch over the sheep. Therefore, God has sent a word to the churches to obey them that have the rule over you, for they watch for your soul. Why are we here this evening? Praise God, because Pastor Hollins is celebrated as the pastor. Praise God, she is the one, hallelujah, that serves the Lord in word and doctrine. And I often wondered why the Apostle Paul used that phrase. Praise God, we are to honor those who serve in word and doctrine. We live in a time today of the mega church, and right. Some churches have many pastors. Right. Some pastors are music pastors. Others are children pastors. But the Apostle Paul made it specific for you. You are to give double honor to the person that serves the church in word and doctrine. The pastor is the chief interpreter of scripture in the house of the Lord. So that person is worthy of double honor. Yes. I want to make this bold statement today, that the pastor is worth following. The Bible says in Jeremiah, praise God, 3:15, that the Lord has appointed your pastor. You don't have any business out looking for a pastor. God said, I give you pastor. And he said, after my heart, oh, thank you, Jesus. Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 11 says, and he gave some apostles and some prophets and some pastors and teachers, some evangelists, oh God, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the whole body, yeah, till we come all in the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God. Oh, God makes special people for this office and he arms them, and then they become dangerous. In other words, he equips them for and prepares them to lead the sheep. He gives them special grace and favor that even when they are under attack, even when they are disrespected and treated unfairly, even when they are left alone, they will not have fear. Praise God. Because the Lord gives pastors spiritual boldness. Hallelujah. Can you say amen? Yeah. These special ones that God has promoted, that God has elevated, that God has lifted up their heads. These individuals, they have learned to trust in God. God will bring them through every trial. God will bring them through every tribulation. And if you follow them, gonna make it out all right. Leadership, that's worth following. Needs the office of the pastor. Romans chapter 10, verse 14 and 15. How can you hear without a preacher? How can he preach except he be sent? I found out in my pastoral ministry that every pastor is going to face three challenges. Number one, the challenge to pray and have a prayer life. Challenge to press in difficult times. Can you say yes? Number three, they will have the challenge to praise God in difficult moments. Praise Him when things are going well. Praise Him when things are not going well. Somebody shout glory. Shout glory. Woo. If we accept these challenges, that we are in position to win. Thank God for the pastor that prays. Prayer is so vital in the arsenal of the pastor, because prayer is talking to God. Prayer is communicating with God for every direction in your life. God said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, the word. But I got news for you. Nobody in the church is equal to the pastor, but it is the Lord's doings, and it is marvelous in our eyes. God bless you, Pastor Gwen A. Hollins. May you be blessed. May the Lord give you many years to serve, to lead, and to rule in the house of God at the New Faith Tabernacle Christian Church. God bless you and God keep you. This is my prayer for you.